All right, so one of the things that, so this is basically some of the properties of the amplifier and noise in the amplifier, but let's look at some of the other stages that we've dealt with. One other stage that I'd like to make some comments about is that the diffusion amplifier. So I'm interested in the input preferred voltage. And we know in general we have to have both the voltage and current source at the input. But let's, at low frequencies, we know that since the impedance here is high, it's dominated by the voltage noise. So let's just worry about the input preferred voltage noise and noise in general. So what are the noise sources? Well, there are a few. Let's just consider the thermal noise sources. Two-channel noise sources. And then you have the two resistor noise sources. So each one of these are 4KT over RD, and this is like 4KT gamma. This is a low, it's a long channel noise. GM, in general, GD0. So, what can you say about the differential noise at the output? So we know that we can deal with this differential. Let's say this is purely differential. We know we can use the half circuits, right? And the half circuit, what is the equivalent of half circuit of this thing? Right? And we already analyzed this. So what is the input preferred noise of this half, or the output noise, both. So we know that we have one noise source here, one noise source there. This is exactly the stage that we analyzed. So the output noise, differential output noise, so VO1, let's say, over delta F, is going to be, for this half circuit, would be 4KT RD plus the contribution of this guy, which is gamma GM over RD squared. Right? Basically, just look at the expressions up there. I'm just taking the first two noise sources into account. The first one, this noise source is 4KT over RD. It's injected into a node with a resistance RD, so it's multiplied by RD squared. So it's giving me 4KT RD. This one is 4KT gamma GM. And it's injected into a node with the resistance RD to ground, so it gets multiplied by RD squared. So that's the output noise. And what's the input preferred noise for this? It's this guy divided by GMRD. So it becomes 4KT over GMRD squared plus RD squared, correct. Divided by GMRD squared. GM squared RD squared. Times 4KT gamma over GM. So this is the contribution of the resistor, and this is the contribution of the channel. Or let's say load and the channel. So these are the input preferred noise. I mean, this is exactly the same as what you have up there, the first two terms of that, right? So, because it is the same stage. Now, what about the differential amplifier? For the differential amplifier, what is the differential output? The differential output is here. So would these noise sources cancel each other? Since it's differential?
The noise is not differential, right?
So the noise sources are two sides. Do you agree that the differential voltage is the difference of these noise sources? So you agree that this is, if this is VO1 and this is VO2, VOD, which is the differential, is VO1 minus VO2. So it's the difference of these two voltages. And I can do the same thing, exactly the same thing for VO2. So I can write VO2 is squared over the left, which is exactly the same. It's 4KT, or I can just basically write this. It's equal to VO1. And VI2 is going to be exactly the same. So I can try to trick you. Say, look at this, and and they have the same power. So why can't they cancel? Why don't they cancel?
They're different neutrons.
Hmm?
Because you're adding a power.
Correct. These are stochastic properties. These are signals, right? These are not deterministic signals. So I'm adding two signals, two waveforms, or subtracting two waveforms that are different. They just have the same power. So subtracting them is similar to adding them, essentially, as far as the power is concerned. Right? Because there's zero mean anyway. So just like flipping it. So it's this waveform minus this other part. Function. So the statistical properties of the sum, the difference is the same as the statistical properties of the sum, as far as the second moment is actually concerned. Not, well, the even moments, for instance, for the power, the variance. If I was looking at the mean, then they would, the subtraction, some addition would matter. So, as far as there are, so basically what happens is that it's, what is, so the, what's the total power? What is the VOD, the noise power at the of the differential signal at the output? It's this plus that, right? It's the noise of this guy plus the noise of that guy, the power, in terms of power. The power's at. And why do they add in power? Because they're uncorrelated sources. They're caused by different noise sources. So the total power on the output is going to be twice VO1 over WF, which is basically 8 KT RD plus gamma GM RD squared. And the input referred one would be this divided by GM squared. So it becomes this thing. 8 KT over GM squared RD plus 8 KT gamma over GM. So it has twice as much noise as a common source. The noise power is double. How about its gain? How does this gain, what is the gain, how does the gain of this compare to a common, a basic common source? A single element. For a given GM. So let's say the GM of this transistor is the same as the GM of this transistor. So the gain of the differential amplifier as a whole is what? GMRD. The gain of this guy is GMRD. Minus GMRD. Okay. So you get the same gain if the GMs were the same. But for the GM to be the same, how much current do you have to spend? Twice, right? Because you have to have the same current in both of these guys. So you double the, for twice the power that you've spent, you're getting the same gain and twice the noise. So in, from purely from a noise perspective, which one would you prefer? Is it single ended or differential? The single ended, right? Because your signal to noise ratio, your noise is better. You get generate less noise, and you at the same time you dissipate less power. Differential amplifier gives you other things, right? It just basically gives you common mode rejection and easy biasing, and so a lot of times you may still want to do that, but you have to realize it comes at a cost. It's not free. So you basically get twice the power. Noise power, because you're basically burning twice as much DC power. These are related, these are not two different things. And the same signal gain. So, in terms of noise performance, this guy is inferior. And that's why you rarely see differential amplifiers in highly low noise systems, unless you really have to have something that's differential, right? An op-amp or something like that. If you don't have it, if you want to make something low noise, just pure noise, thermal noise, then you go to single end. But that may not be the best solution because, you know, it's a lot less immune to interference, common mode interference, let's say. say, pickup from line or radiations from the air, things of that sort, things that are deterministic, things that are not generated. And that's one of the fundamental differences between noise and interference. Noise is fundamental to the device. It's generated inside the amplifier, inside the device. It's a physical phenomenon inside. Interference is something that's coming from outside. And it behaves more like a signal, not the noise. But that's something that you need to keep in mind. The same thing is true about the flicker noise, if you do the same thing. The analysis will see. Okay. Now, one last thing I want to say about noise is, what if you have cascade of amplifiers? Let's say you have multiple amplifiers. You can think about them as like a... these are voltage amplifiers referenced to the ground. So this is A1, A2, A3. Let's deal with three for now. And then also. So let's say you have three amplifiers in cascade. This happens a lot of times. You make amplifiers, and we'll see that if you want to actually get high bandwidth, that's one of the scenarios that you want to get. If you want to get high bandwidth, high gain bandwidth product, one way to do it is just to break the gain among different stages. And you've seen some of this in one of your homework problems, and we'll see that a little bit more later. But now each one of these amplifiers has its noise. So you can say each one of them can be represented with an input referred noise. In general, a voltage and a current. But let's say these are high impedance inputs, so we only worry about the input referred voltage noises. So this guy has a VN3 squared over delta F, or VN3 squared. This one has a VN2. This is the input referred noise of this guy. This is the input referred noise of that guy. And then this one has a VN1 squared. Okay? So if you take these three power spectral densities, my question for you is, can I model this whole thing as a new amplifier with a gain of A1 times A2 times A3? And an input preferred noise source of VNT for total over delta F. And if so, what is the source? Well, from a signal perspective, this makes sense, right? It's just the gain, if these are linear amplifiers, the gain is a product of the three gains. So how about noise sources? So there are two ways to do it. How do we refer the noise to the input? Well, you can divide it by the gains, or basically what the standard procedure was to calculate the total transmission at the output. The classic, when in doubt, right? I mean, just confusing definition. So what is the output noise? So how much of this guy appears at the output? It gets multiplied by A1 squared, right? Or let's say these are power gains. Or, well, let's say it's a voltage gain. So this is A3 squared times VN3 squared divided by delta F. Plus, how much of this noise ends up at the output?
A2 squared,
A3 squared, VN2 squared over delta F. And how much of this guy? It's A1 squared plus A2 times A2 squared times A3 squared times VN1 squared. So as far as the output noise is concerned, which one of these noise sources is the most important one? The first one. And that's why it's generally the noise source of the first stage that matters the most. When you make an amplifier, I mean, the first stage is the low noise amplifier. And the more gain you have after that, so the more your signal gets gained up, the less important the noise of subsequent stages are. So in general, you want to make sure that the first stages are as low noise as possible. And once they amplify the signal, then essentially the rest of the noises don't matter because the signal becomes larger and larger. Because the signal here, one way to think about it is that your signal is tiny here. So any noise here will have a larger impact, the same amount of noise. So let's say this noise will be significant. But now your signal here is larger. So if you had the same kind of level of noise, have lower impact. And your signal is yet larger here, and therefore the same level of noise will have even yet less impact on the signal when added to it. So that's the output noise. How about the input preferred noise? So what do? We just divide it by the transfer function of the whole thing, right? Magnitude squared, just A1, A2, A3 squared. So what do we get? So we get V in squared over delta F. It's gonna be, you see this term appears exactly as it was, because it gets divided by V3. So the first stage of noise is there untouched, so it's basically the same thing, it's unmodified. But then, what is the impact of this guy? When you take the second stage, you divide it by A1, A2, A3 squared, so you're left with A1. So it's 1 over A1 squared times Vn2 over delta F. Plus, now the impact of this guy is reduced by the gain of the stages prior to that. So it's basically 1 over A1 squared, A2 squared times Vn3 squared over delta F. So this tells you that the gain of the noise of the first stage appears, the power appears verbatim at the input, so it's already there. But the gain, the noises of the subsequent stages are reduced when they are referred to the input by the gain preceding them. So this noise source is preceded by this gain. So its impact is reduced by the gain preceding it. And this guy is preceded by this much gain beforehand, so its impact is reduced. So this is called Free's formula. The name of the guy. I mean, this is one way of writing it. There are different ways of writing this. And in general, if you have higher order terms, basically the same thing happens. The gain of the subsequent stages are, the noises of subsequent stages are reduced by the gain preceding them. And that tells you that if you're designing something like this, you really want to focus your energy on minimizing the noise of this guy. Minimizing the noise of this guy is not going to do you much. Unless your gain is really low. Your previous stages gain are low, which basically defeats the purpose of using those stages anyway. That's why you start with a low noise amplifier. And nobody even bothers to tell you what the noise of like a baseband amplifier and a receiver is, the last stage. And it's huge compared to the input stage. But it doesn't matter because it's preceded by a lot of gain, so it's attenuated. Okay? Any questions? So this concludes our discussion of noise. Any general questions about noise? Anything you want to discuss about noise or ask?